Now the next topic is don't destroy your friends with your tongue. Today you can add to that with your keyboard. Why? The biggest damage that people do to each other today is by spreading rumors in the internet. For instance, it's a very common thing today. They have news. They put somebody on the news that did something not so good. Right away, thousands of comments. Yeah, I know him. He went with me to school. He was always garbage. I'm not surprised. I know so many things about this garbage guy. What do you need this for? The guy already is up to here with problems. He's sitting and crying. He's in jail or whatever he is. Who knows where? He's already realizing that his life is maybe over. Why do you destroy him even more? Would you like people to do the same thing to you? Or sometimes a person is about to succeed, you ruin the deal for him. Why? Pure jealousy. Not because he's bad. How is this guy? I'm about to do a partnership with him. Don't get near him. He's not honest. I'm telling you, he's the biggest crook in the neighborhood. Be careful for him. Oh, really? Thank you for warning me. Thank you, thank you, thank you. In the end, he was a great guy. The worst that it happens is when you're about to get married to someone, especially by the religious world, they don't meet in a bar. They have a joke. Our fathers met their wives in the Be'er. Be'er means a well. Bet Aleph Resh. We meet our wives in a bar, also Bet Aleph Resh. Be'er and bar. It's a little bit of a difference. So, one thing is, sometimes a person calls you and he asks you about someone that he wants to date and you're jealous. I'll give you an example. Two girls from a religious yeshiva, Bet Yaakov, supposed to be the best. So they learn in a good yeshiva. Their friend got engaged. She's about to get married in a month. They sit on a bus with jealousy. They suffer so much that she got engaged. And they sit on a bus and talk. And there was one woman behind them. How did she get engaged? How did this guy even want her? She's not even pretty. She's not even this. She's overweight. She's too skinny. She's too short. She's too tall. She's this. She's from a horrible family. She never had a good grade. How is it possible? I'm sure he doesn't know who she is. They talk and talk for an hour. Then the woman behind, she got up and said, girls, I'm so relieved now. Thank you very much. You gave me a wonderful information that I needed. The boy is my son. And he was about to lose his life based on your story. So I'm going to cancel this engagement. I don't know how to thank you. Thank you for warning me. Wow, it's a miracle by Hashem. So these girls realize what they just did. It's all a lie, what they say. It was anger of jealousy. You know when you're jealous what you say. No, no, ma'am. No, 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 don't get the wrong thing. No, no, she's not so bad. Really, really, don't cancel it. Wait, don't go. No, no, I'm in a rush. No, no, please, come here. No, no, she's not so bad. Well, I just heard an hour that she's worse than a murderer. No, no. Okay, listen, can we be honest with you? We only say everything we say because we're dying from jealousy. Really, that's the truth. Forget everything we say. We're dying from jealousy. How did she get engaged and we are still not? You sure it's only that? Yeah, we promise you she's great, she has great marks, she's beautiful, she's modest, she comes from a good family. Her father actually is a rabbi. You can call this number and find out. He's teaching in this yeshiva. Everything the opposite. It's a true story. It really happened in Israel. So the mother said, oh, great, I'm so relieved. By the way, I'm not the mother. Oh my God, I just wanted to teach you how you can murder a person's life. Who knows what kids they will have? Who knows what wonderful things this family is supposed to have? With your mouth, you destroyed it. Same thing in business, same thing in everything in life. In today's generation, the hand is very light on the keyboard. Right away, destruction. Publishing on Facebook, publishing on YouTube. Today, have people, they film things that they're not supposed to film in hidden camera and put it on YouTube anonymously and destroy the life of people. Not only that, there are people in Israel, they call you, they record the conversation, and they put it on YouTube. The whole world has to find out in our conversation with him. I ask a lawyer in Israel, what is going on here? Sue them. He said, no, that's the law here. If you were a part of the conversation, you're allowed to publish it. If you record two strangers, you're not a part of the conversation, it's against the law. But if you in the conversation, leading the person to say what you want him to say, record him and put it for the whole world to hear, what about you destroyed his life? His wife will jump from the window and kill herself from the embarrassment. The children will never be able to go out. They'll never be able to get married. He's going to lose his business. It's worse than a death penalty. Legal. What do we care about him? Let him die. As long as there's juicy information. That's Israel. That's America. That's what's happening without Torah. The laws in Israel, you're allowed to say anything you want on a person, on a newspaper, and in public, as long as it's true. If you would prove that it was a lie, you are subject to a lawsuit. But if it's true, you have the right to publish it all over the world and destroy him. How can it be? It's worse than Sodom and Gomorrah. Ma. If a person has a sickness, he's embarrassed that people would know about it. Who gave you permission to publish it to the world? Now everyone looks at him, poor guy. It's embarrassing. If a person had something 20 years ago when he was a kid, he got caught doing something bad. But in the meantime, he became righteous. He's a much better person. He never, ever did it again. It's wonderful today. You want to hurt him, you publish it. When he was in my school, that's what he did. You're done. You killed him. People cannot think, oh, there, stay away from this guy. This is how constantly Jews destroy Jews on the media every day. That brings us a lot of problems, because when Hashem sees that his children killing each other with their mouth and hands, what do you expect him to do? If it was up to me, I would change the laws in Israel tremendously. First, I would make a law, you're not allowed to publish any negative thing against any person, even if it's true. Needless to say, if it's a lie, it's against the law. It's nobody's business. Rule number two, everyone that publishes things on the internet must identify himself with a real name and picture. Face of the picture, your picture, and your name. You want to write and murder someone on the internet and destroy his life, stand behind what you say. Don't use a fake name. The IP address automatically publishes the name of the person. Whether you write good, whether you write bad, everybody should know who you are. That would prevent 99% of the murders in the internet. 99% of that will not take place. Why? All the cowards, they're only brave when they use a fake name. If they have to expose their real name, who would have the guts to write even the truth about his biggest enemy? It's embarrassing to write such dirt. It's making you a lowlife. But when you hide behind a fake name, nobody knows anyway. Let's add some juice, some salt and pepper to the story. They must change the laws. One more thing, in Israel and in the United States, when a person gets caught by the police catch him, and he's a suspect in a crime, whether it's a big crime, small crime, right away, they publish him all over the media. Pictures, videos, Channel 4, Channel 5, reporters by his home, his poor children come home. What do you think about what your father did? What do you think about what your husband did? 10 months later, the police closed the case against him from no evidence. They didn't find anything. There was somebody called the police. Hey, this guy is laundering money. And the way he does it, someone comes, he gives him this, and he gives him instead cash under the table. Made up the whole lie against his competition. FBI come, or Israeli police. Excuse me, you're under arrest for money laundering. Put your hands behind your back. They shut his business. All customers outside. They grab all his stuff. They check his computer. 10 months of harassment. In the end, they see he's crystal clean. His life is destroyed. He lost millions of dollars. His business is off. His wife divorced him. His children went to crime because of the depression. Everything got destroyed in his life. 10 months later, two lines in a newspaper. Police closed the case against Mr. X for lack of evidence. Nobody saw it. 20 years later, people see him. Hey, how are you? Pretend he doesn't know him. Well, he's a criminal. He doesn't know. In the meantime, he was innocent. You're done with him. It's a dead sentence before the trial. It should not be like that. They should make the law. The only way you can publish, you should never be published, ever. It's nobody's business. Let him go to jail and finish. But if you're already dying to publish because you want to sell newspapers, only after he was convicted in a court. After conviction, at least I understand where you're coming from. But as long as he's a suspect, many of the cases end with nothing. Who gave you permission to murder a person like this? It's worse than physical murder. And why children have to suffer for nothing? Why his wife, why his brother, siblings, parents, neighbors, everyone suffer from it. It can be 1,000 people sitting and crying for weeks, for months. He has to spend hundreds of thousands of dollars for lawyers. Why? In the end, he's innocent. That's what's happening every day in our society, here in Israel. That's the freedom of democracy. One person told me, so you basically want dictatorship. You don't want democracy. But that's what's beautiful about this country. Speaking about America, which Israel is the same idea. The freedom of speech. I say, who's to say that my freedom of speech will be your end of life? Because I'm interested to publish information, I have permission to murder you? Freedom of speech? Freedom of speech if you don't destroy the life of others, yes. Freedom of speech on the expense of killing another person because you're interested to get attention? Or to sell newspapers? What kind of freedom is that? It's the freedom of murder, not freedom of speech. This is what we speak about, the destruction of Lashon Hara. The Torah say there are three sins in Judaism that are the worst sins in the Torah. Murder, sex crimes with a married woman, belongs to another man, and idol worshiping, bowing down to an idol. Those three sins, even if a goy puts a gun to your head and says, I want you to do it, otherwise I kill you, you're not allowed to agree. You have to say, Shema Israel, and give up your life. Kill him, if not, I'll kill you. Kill me. I'm sorry. I'm not going to kill him. Go with this married woman, if not, I kill you. Kill me. I'm not going to do it. Bow down to my Buddha, if not, I'll blow your head off. Shema Israel, Hashem Elokeinu, Hashem Echad, go ahead. I'm not going to do it. Anything else, you must do. Do this, do that, eat pork, drive on Shabbat. If not, I'll kill you. You must do. Those three, you're not allowed to violate, even if you lose your life. It's a very big test. The Torah says there's one sin equal to all three combined. Lashon Hara, gossip. Spreading rumors, speaking bad about people in public. The first temple was destroyed for the first three crimes that I mentioned. The second temple was destroyed for gossip and hatred, false hatred. People hate each other and hurt each other with their mouth and words. The first temple was rebuilt after 7 years, meaning God forgave us and gave us another chance. The second temple was destroyed. 2,000 years was never rebuilt. Why? To show you the horrible weight of this sin, Lashon Hara.